The question is, why are our children so lacking in intelligence now?
Yes.
Or how can we make them like?
And how can we get them to become more intelligent? First of all, intelligence is not a monopoly of the male. The men, and both male and female, Allah is blessed with intelligence. And both male and female have an obligation to pursue knowledge. Obligation to pursue knowledge. It's not only the men, it's the women as well. Intelligence, you're born as Allah says that He's created you the way He created the trees. وَاللَّهُ أَنْبَتَكُمْ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ النَّبَاتَ. So human beings are like trees, according to Surah An-Nur. Some trees are ornamental. So you find a man who is, my gosh, they say, this is not a human being, this is an angel. That's how Yusuf alayhi salam. They are so handsome. And some women are blessed with such beauty. These are ornamental trees with flowers. Some trees are meant for wood to make furniture. And so some men are born with a different aptitude. Some trees are medicinal. Some trees are for fruit and some for food. So Allah says that He has created us with different aptitudes. In one verse of the Quran, in nasayakum lashatta, you are functionally different. So each human being is born with a different aptitude. And then there's another verse in Surah Al-Isra, I'm trying to remember now. قُلْ كُلُّ يَعْمَلُ عَلَى شَاكِلَتِي قُلْ كُلُّ يَعْمَلُ عَلَى شَاكِلَتِي رَبُّكُمْ أَعْلَمُ بِمَنْ هُوَ أَهْدَى سَبِيلًا. Each of you will work and function in the basis of the aptitude that Allah has given to you. So some are born with exceptional intelligence. One of the great gifts that I got in life is insight. And I recognize this since I was a boy. And my father had this insight. Because of this insight, now because I'm devoting my time and my effort to the study of the Quran, Allah blesses me to understand some verses of the Quran. Never understood this way before. Some people are born with mechanical skills. And some people are born with artistic skills. I was also born with oratory, a natural gift that Allah gave to me. So even though a child is born, you do not know what aptitude the child has. But mother has to look and wait, the teacher has to take the child, the imam, until you know what is the aptitude of the child. And then you train that child to move on that road. I never started to really grow and become a big tree until I met Maulana Fathur Rahman Ansari at the age of 18. Before that, all the schools I attended, all the colleges and so on, I was just an ordinary student, but we'd had some oratory. But from the time I listened to him at the age of 18, he came to Trinidad, I was spellbound. And he ignited a fire inside of me, a light inside of me. And when I reached when I went to Egypt, I couldn't find that scholarship that would excite me. When I came to Pakistan and I became his student, that was when I started to grow. That was when I started to grow. Shoot up. So parents have to check, see what kind of child you have. And so you steer the child in the direction to which the child has grown, Allah has bestowed upon the child aptitude. But for the native intelligence that the child has, instead of allowing the child to be corrupted with the television screen, you must allow your child to interact with nature, with the trees. Let your child go with the trees and the flowers and the river and the rain and the birds and the stars and the clouds and all these things. And in this interaction with nature, the intelligence is fortified and is not corrupted by television. You should have conversations with your child. My son was 7 years of age. I was in Karachi. And every morning that he has breakfast before he goes to school, I will teach him the Seerah, the life of the Prophet. It took me six months to complete the Seerah. You know what he said when I finished? He said, Papa, start again. Start again. Start it again. So if you spend time with your children to fill their hearts with that nourishment, which is beneficial for them, and the life of the Prophet, mashallah, that is good food for the heart, then the intelligence of the child can keep on growing and growing. And finally, good company. You keep bad company, you'll be corrupted. You keep good company, then that good company will allow you to grow.